Welcome to Mirror Domain, Stranger Things, Season 3, Chapter 6, E Pluribus Unum. E Pluribus Unum. Now, I'm not too up to date with my Latin, but I'm pretty sure that that is a saying that's on a lot of American coins. But, yeah, let's not get too digressed here. Let's talk about this Season 3, Stranger Things, Chapter 6. And give you my quick review, my thoughts. Okay, so where were we? We were back at that hospital where this mind flayer beast has formed into it, and they're chasing the group. They basically try to flee from this beast to a cabin, and they try to use Eleven's powers to try to find, I think it was Billy. They try to go into Billy's mind? Is that it? I can't remember. Yeah. And they try to see where Billy was when he first got influenced by this entity. And it's a dangerous thing. And we get to see a lot of Billy's past, like when he was a young boy. And it kind of made us a little bit sympathize with him. So I can see what they were trying to do with that. I'm not sure if it really worked for me. I'm going to have to stew on it. It may have worked for you guys. But eventually that monster gets there and rips through the ceiling. It claws onto Eleven, which leaves her with a rather significant wound, I would think. It's got to be, right? I mean, her leg is taking a beating there. Okay, what else? Okay, moving on with Steve and Robin, who are going to get interrogated by the Russians. They're basically just trying to ask them where do they work, because the guy doesn't believe them when they're saying that they just work for an ice cream place. It's kind of a, yeah, that's an interesting thing. Dustin and Erica are escaping, and they realize, well, we can't really leave them behind. And more or less, they feel like they have to go back and try to save them. But what really was interesting was the dialogue between Steve and Robin when they're all tied up and stuff, and they're talking about how can we get out of here and stuff like that, how they were dealing with that situation. I mean, Steve gets a beating in this episode. He gets a thumping. I mean, whew. Yeah, and the makeup was really well done. I like that. Okay, so what else happens? Mayor Klein says that he's going to have this 4th of July festival, this fair that we see, and he gets kind of accosted by that Russian guy saying, no, you got to use this event to try to lure in the kids. And they're like, ah, okay, whatever. And yeah, that's pretty much it. You can tell that this one was just kind of setting things up. It was driving people towards that one location. I'm guessing that this fair is right next to the mall, so everything is going to be leading towards the mall, and I think that's where the big climax is. I'm pretty sure that that's going to be where it is. As far as this episode, it was okay. It didn't really blow my mind. There was nothing in it that made me go, wow, yeah, but there was some really cool stuff in there, especially with Eleven and what she was doing with all of her vision stuff. I found like that was really cool, despite some of the stuff that, maybe the stuff with Billy, it was well done. It's just, if they're showing all that stuff, you got to think that they're setting him up to be kind of like not the scapegoat, but they're probably going to kill him, and they're going to be like, okay, his redemption for treating the kids like a butthead. He's going to you know, rise up and not allow the beast to get him. I don't know. I'm grasping at straws. Anyway, yeah, that's pretty much it. Oh, you know, a lot of the dialogue that happened with Alexi. I'm really liking Alexi and Murray. Their interactions. They're speaking Russians to each other, and that was really fun stuff. I like that stuff. And yeah, that's about it. I think that's all I can say for this episode. Basically, Murray thinks that Alexi will try to escape, but Hopper says no, and basically Alexi doesn't escape, and he goes back with them and teaches them what they need to do to destroy the machine that's causing the tear in the upside down. And that's what I'm saying. It's all leading us towards that, to that final big showdown. And, yeah, E Pluribus Unum. I'm guessing the title comes from these things, like the goo that merges to become the big monster, is like the entities that he makes that look like other people. I'm guessing that's where the title comes from. Anyway, let me know what you guys thought, what the title was around. I'm pretty sure that that's it. I pretty much like this episode. I would give it a 7 out of 10. Yeah, there we go. All right. You can see my last episode review right here, and you can see the next one just right there. My name is James, and you're watching Mirror Domains. If you've liked what you've seen, please hit that thumbs up button and subscribe.